right, Stock Monster fans, what do we got here? Something called the Outer Space Connection. Let's check it out.
Museums and research centers took part in the explorations. There are no actors in the film. Every location is real. The facts that will be presented are true. This may be the most startling and controversial film you'll ever see. Of Nazca tell a story of explorers from outer space. The secret of the story has been learned. The visitors have been here. They have been described in many ways by many men, from primitive drawings to detailed histories. You are witnessing the strange, as yet unexplained event called the Carillion Effect. Its presence has been suspected for years. Only recently could the living spark be photographed in film. An ancient marine creature that died 450 million years ago displays the residue of an ancient life force.
Oh, look at that. Isn't that fantastic?
Watch closely. This is weird, but it's real. Look it up.
And when I do, I'm going to place it on the glass electrode here so that you can see very clearly where the leaf has been cut. Is that good for you, Clark, for framing? Okay. Now, when we turn on the Carillion apparatus, I think, hopefully...
You can still see the outline of where the cut piece was.
In outline, the part of the leaf that has been cut away. We call that the phantom leaf effect.
The rocks from which they have come may be as much as 1 million years old. The ancient bacteria, never before seen by man, are once again growing and reproducing 1 million years after they first came into existence. Immortality is possible. Message from space. In the sequence of sounds, Duncan Lunan has found a specific message of a population moving from the second planet to the sixth in Epsilon Bautes. And then where? Technology. It is unfortunate that we can no longer afford to explore the lunar surface, for it is just barely possible that somewhere on the moon are the traces of previous explorers. To make a new home of planet Earth. 300 miles away, on another plane, lie the strange lines of Nazca. From ground level, the lines are very shallow scratches, barely 4 inches deep. Yet they have remained intact for thousands of years, serve the same function. April 15th, 1966. A television cameraman filming a commercial in a helicopter saw and filmed something that has still not been explained.
The Incas.
The Inca knew nothing of the wheel, and yet their roads are still in use today. They had no alphabet, yet we are asked to believe they developed an engineering technology that built structures such as this.
After the planes were in the air a few hours, they vanished. 5 radios did not give a coherent reason why they vanished. The men were never seen again.
The Bermuda Triangle.
The planes was ever found. There was no radio contact after they were lost.
And finally, the Yucatan Peninsula. The deep jungles of Central America make an ideal hiding place for a colony cut off from its home planet. To this day, the steaming, malaria-ridden lowlands of the Yucatan Peninsula remain largely unexplored. We have found cuneiform tablets that mark the phases of Venus, the 4 moons of Jupiter, and the satellites of Saturn. None of these bodies or events can be seen without a telescope, a device invented 3,000 years after the tablets were carved. The knowledge must have come from outer space. in the Mochica grave more than 1,500 years ago. It is among the hardest of all minerals, yet it was cut, polished, and shaped by a technology that theoretically could not have existed at that time. Other hands carved this skull. The British Museum calls it 15th century Aztec. But why would the Aztecs, who never created naturalistic art, suddenly render in crystal a skull?
Result.
At the Yerkes Regional Primate Center, scientists implant monkeys with electrodes. The experiment stimulates the brain with radio waves and thereby controls behavior. Dr. Orgel.
In the 19th century, there were two theories about how life could have got to the Earth from outside. One theory, which was due to Lord Kelvin in England, said that life arrived as a spore carried on a meteorite.
Spaceships would have to spend hundreds of years in flight. To transport and sustain life over such an extended time, space-traveling civilization would have to ship an entire colony of men across a galaxy in suspended animation. Do ancient drawings commemorate the arrival of life on Earth? In the light of present-day knowledge, the ancient Egyptian art of mummification seems an echo of modern-day preparations for space travel. Immortality.
It's very possible that the Great Pyramid of Giza was constructed by a race of scientists having far superior knowledge to our own. The fact that the Great Pyramid is level over an area of 14 acres within one half of an inch and is the world's most accurately aligned building to true north, and the fact that it incorporates higher mathematics in its very design, indicate that a superior race designed the Great Pyramid.
Cloning.
Scientists like Dr. Brothers are opposed to cloning human beings, for cloning creates a rigid mold that will stabilize one form, and that runs counter to the design of human creation, that is, in chimpanzee society. And so Tim asks, can Tim groom Lana? Yes.
I'm sure we all remember the Mayan calendar that was supposed to end a few years ago.
An inscription tells us that the modern period will end December 24th, 2011 AD. Did the final experiments at cloning take place here, near the Great Pyramid of Uxmal? December 24th, Christmas Eve, 2011 AD. On that day, they may return to seek the fate of the colony left on Earth. Perhaps they will settle in the jungle of Uxmal, where, according to legend, Mayan priests talk to their gods through a black, shiny, glass-like rock.
All right, let's talk about The Outer Space Connection. It's a movie that I have on a VHS tape. I inherited that tape from my Schlockmeister brother, Jeff, about 10, 15 years ago or so. 15 years ago, probably. And it's a documentary. It's not been released on DVD. I think there are some DVD-R bootlegs floating around of this thing. But so I burned my own DVD-R and made my own homemade box art here. So here we go. Outer Space Connection. It's a documentary. It came out in 1975, I believe. And it's narrated by Rod Serling. I think it was one of the last things he did, because I think he passed away later in 1975 as well. So it's kind of got that Twilight Zone feel to it. It's basically a documentary that's trying to convince us that there are aliens out there from outer space that have come down
to visit us. Maybe they're here around us now. And this documentary alleges to provide proof of that. However, I wouldn't go that far. But it is kind of fascinating. It kind of plays out like an episode of In Search Of, if you remember that show with Leonard Nimoy back in the late 70s or so. They show stuff like, they talk about cloning, for example. They talk about the ancient Mayans and the Incas and the Nazca lines, which I think are also in Peru, the pyramids. You know, they talk about how the technology didn't exist for these people to create such things, yet it did exist. There's outlines, kind of like crop circle type things, where there's you can only see them from the sky. You know, these were created for this and that. They're basically trying to tell us that a lot of this stuff comes from outer space. They actually interview a guy also who claims that some sort of scientist guy who claims that we've received a couple of signals from outer space from this other galaxy, and they name the name of the galaxy, which I can't quite remember. I actually looked this guy up online to see if he was legit, and he is. He actually was, and this is the theory that he held, that there was some sort of signals from outer space from this other galaxy. Everything in this show that I looked up, and I did look up a few things, ring true. In other words, at least, I guess you can't say for sure whether or not it is true, but at least it wasn't made up. These were real people who were believing these things, real scientists and such. So anyway, that's pretty much it about this. Again, this was available from Sun. Sun Classics put these movies out. They did a lot of similar type movies, and most of those movies just aren't available on DVD. Never have. They did those Grizzly Adams movies, Life and Times of, Beyond Death's Door, something I reviewed quite a while back. None of those things have ever seen the light of day on DVD for whatever reason. Wish they would, though. So anyway, it's The Outer Space Connection. Curious if anybody else has seen this. It does seem to have some regard, this film, this documentary. People seem to really like it, those who have seen it. So this is a highly respected film in its genre. So check it out. Let me know what you think about it and leave some comments down below. The Outer Space Connection. Watch it. Bye.